Good morning everyone and welcome to the session. So let's see some trade setups for Monday, that is December 2nd, 2019. Now recalling our Nifty and Bank Nifty setups, as I've been telling, the width between pivot and R1 is high. So there will be a very less volatility this month and it will be hard for the index to touch R1. So R1 will act as a strong resistance. And at the same time, I've also informed you that since last three sessions, price has been opening gap up. So this is one gap, this is second gap, and this is third gap. So people who have enjoyed profits, they'll definitely try to exit their positions before the end of the month so that they can get with a new view for the next month and they can establish some new positions. So one, it did not even touch R1, so our first point was correct. And second, definitely there was a profit booking seen here. So there was around 0.8% fall in Nifty if you compare it with the previous close. Now, what we also wanted was that Nifty should come back at least after touching R1 or even if even before it touches R1. So what will happen is this becomes a very narrow range for Nifty, and for the next month, that is for December, we'll have narrow pivot points. So if there are narrow pivot points, based on the opening of the month, we can decide on which side to be. So I've calculated pivot points for the coming month. Very simple. I've gone to monthly time frame and I have noted down this month's high, low and close, because on daily time frame the pivot points would be valid for a complete month, and for the calculation part, high, low and close of previous month are taken. So for the month of December, we'll need to take high, low, close of November, and whatever pivot points we get, those will be valid for the complete month of December. So high is around 12,158.8, low is around 11,802.65, and close is around 12,056.05. So these things I have noted down in this Excel sheet, and based on the calculations, I have got these pivot points. Now the duty here would be to note down the distance between R1 and central pivot point, and then central pivot point and S1. So on the upper side we have 200 rupees and on the downside we have 150 rupees of gap, which is very, very less. So this itself shows that this particular month, in the month of December, it is going to be a trending month. Now in which direction it is going to trend, bearish or bullish, that we can say only with relation to the opening price of Monday and where does it close by the end of the day. So crossover and cross under of central pivot point is what we need when we are talking about distance between pivot points. So let's just compare this distance of 200 points and 152 points with this current month's difference. So pivot point distance between R1 and central pivot point of November, it was around 500 points. And then in between pivot point and R1 of October, 11,900 and 11,300. So this is around 600 points. But in the month of December, we have only 200 points difference between R1 and pivot. And between pivot and S1, it is further less. So based on the opening and based on the close in the month of on the first day of December, we'll get to know, or whichever happens first, either the crossover and cross under of central pivot point or in relation to the opening of the first day of December, we'll come to know where is it going to head. But one thing is for sure, that it is going to be a trending month in December. So even in Bank Nifty, we were able to see some profit booking in the first session itself when price opened gap down, and only by the end of the day it was able to recover. So this is what we anticipated, and the same was visible here. Let's see the distance of pivot points for Bank Nifty as well. High 32,157.05. Low is 30,013.65. And close 31,946.1. So pivot and R1, it is around 1358, and pivot and S1, the distance is 784. So both Nifty and Bank Nifty are showing that mostly in between pivot and S1, there is a narrow range, and if at any point of time in the coming month price closes below the central pivot point, that will lead to a strong bearish rally in both the indices. And now coming to the stock picks. So first is Bajaj Finserv. One thing what we are able to see here is the RSI bearish divergence. But the point to be noted here is that the stock is RSI value is still trading above 60. Then we'll draw one trendline resistance as well here. So within intraday session, if the trendline is breached, you can be on bearish side, but that's too risky. So this is only for positional purpose, and it's up to you if you want to play it in intraday session. But as per me, this is only for intraday session. So this is the RSI bearish divergence, and the candle low here is 9089.6, and yesterday's candle low is 9095.3, so it is very much near. So what I would say is, within the intraday session, if this common low is broken, then you can be on bearish side, and it is going to be largely bearish until the end of the day. The reason for that is, on daily time frame there is a bearish divergence and there is a common low here. So if this low is broken, people will panic and they'll be more on bearish side. In Hero MotoCorp, there is a common low of 24.25, first candle, second candle and third candle. So these three candles are sharing a common low. So below 24.25, one needs to be bearish on Hero MotoCorp. So whatever stocks I am discussing right now, they are for intraday purpose. MNM. This is one low here, around 528, and yesterday also 528.25. So definitely below 528, this stock is going to be bearish. Then Marico around 362, that is the common high here amongst all these candles. So above 362 within intraday, you can at least aim for 1% movement on the upside. Then Tata Motors, these three candles are sharing a similar low around 160. So below that, Tata Motors will exhibit bearishness. Then Wipro, see the price level of 236.5, it acted as support for all these candles. Again, for this large red candle, even yesterday also it was not able to penetrate below that, and this is also a mother candle setup. So inside this trading range of this candle, inside the high and low of this candle, rest of the three candles have traded. So the low of this candle now holds a very important significance. So below the low of 236.5, one needs to be bearish in Wipro. So these are the stocks and indices for Monday. Thank you all for joining.